Hey everyone, in this video I will be showing you how to use Google's Gemini's image editing API. So in this, basically we will be sending the image along with the prompt, and we will be accessing Gemini 2.0 flash experimental model which has image editing capabilities, and that will be sending us the edited image in the response. So I have already done the entire tutorial on how you can generate an image by using the same model. If you want to watch that, you can just click on the card that is appearing on top. So now let's get started with the editing API. So for this, just Google AI Studio. You'll be getting the first link. Select that and make sure that you are signing in with your Google account. And in case if you want to try the Gemini 2.0 flash experimental, you can just try it out over here. And to the left, we are having this API documentation. Just open it. And in this documentation, to the left, we are having this image generation. Select it. And if you scroll down over here, you'll be having the code, how we can generate image by using Python. Below that, here we are having image out guide. So just select this. And we'll be taken to this GitHub page where we'll be having the image out collab notebook. For example, here, basically we will be having all the code. Here we can just select run in Google Collab. So basically we can make use of this code that is available over here, because they are already having the code over here for editing the image. For example, this is the code for editing the image, and this is the code how you will be sending that particular image along with the prompt. So they literally have everything set up for us. We're just going to create a REST API using Flask. Okay, so now let's get started with the code. So for this, we will be requiring two packages. One is going to be the Google GenAI package, and another one is going to be Flask. So copy this and go to Visual Studio Code and make sure that you are creating a new Python file like this. And in the terminal, paste it. We won't be requiring this stuff. You can just have it pip install and this one. Yeah, hit enter. And I have already installed, so this is fine. Next is going to be pip install Flask. All right. So let's begin with the coding. It's going to be from the Flask, okay, which is used to create endpoint. It's going to be import. We will be importing Flask request JSONify as well as send underscore file thing. So we'll be basically requiring all this from Flask. And just come to the next line. It's going to be import base64. This is an inbuilt package which is basically used to convert the response image. Okay. And next is going to be from Google import GenAI. Okay. This is the main package which establishes a connection between our code as well as the Gemini API. And next is going to be from Google dot GenAI import. It's going to be types. All right. And next is going to be import IO. And after this, we will be creating our Flask variable, which is app equal to Flask underscore underscore name underscore underscore. So you need to have it something like this. And next, we will be initializing our Gemini client. Client equal to GenAI, which is this particular thing that we imported, dot client with a capital C. And inside that, we need to have API underscore key. And within double quotes, we need to pass our API key. So for getting the Gemini AI API key, what we can do is, again, go back to Google AI Studio, select get API key. And if you're already having some existing API key, you can just click this and copy this. If you don't, click create API key, select a project and just give create API key in existing project. And you can just copy this. In case if you want to delete it, you can just delete it also. And it's better to use them in an environment variable. So now let's just create our API endpoint. So for that, it's going to be at app.route. And inside this, we need to pass our path. So we can just have the path as edit underscore image, and it's going to be a post operation, so it's going to be methods post, something like this. And in the next line we will be having our function, so it's going to be define edit underscore image. So this will be our function, and so basically we will be sending the image as well as the prompt from our postman in body and form data. So we need to fetch that in our code. So I'll just type it and this will make sense later when I will be explaining you. So it's going to be prompt equal to request dot form dot get prompt. Okay, so basically we are getting the request from this form data, so that's the reason why we are having like this. And we can just copy the same, and this is for the prompt, that is the text. For example, in case I'm sending an image and I'm asking to like change the color, that is going to be the prompt. And another one is going to be the image itself, so let me have it as image file request dot files dot get over here. So it's going to be files, and the name of the key is going to be image. Okay, and you can just have a condition like saying if that particular image or prompt is not being sent by the user, you can just throw an error, missing image or something. So you can just do that. So now I'm just going to like open the image. So it's going to be image equal to image in caps. So we need to also import this one from PIL import image. This is going to be a default package, so just add this. It's going to be image dot open circular bracket, it's going to be IO. This is the one we already imported over here, IO dot, it's going to be bytes IO, and inside this we will be passing our image file. So it's going to be this variable image file dot read. Okay, you need to just have this function over here. And now we will be passing both our prompt and image to the Gemini model. So for doing that, we are already having the code in our Google Code app. So if you just scroll down, you'll be having generate images, and below that you are having edit images. All right, so basically you will just copy this particular code. So just going to copy this and paste it over here. So just paste it, and here we need to do some modifications. The first thing that we need to do is we'll be having this model ID. So for that, to the top you must go, you'll be having this Gemini 2.0 flash experimental. Just copy this and just going to replace this. Okay, just replace this one. And next, here we are having the prompt inside this contents. We already are getting the prompt from the request. Okay, so we're just going to completely remove this text, and rather that we are going to have the text as prompt. All right, and next, instead of having here PIL the image open, we are already having here the image from postman, so you can just put a image over here also. That's it, now we are good. So now we need to process this particular response, because it is the one that is going to have our image. So for that, again go to the Google Colab, and here see they are passing this response that we get from here to this display response function. So here we are having that display response function. So we are just going to copy this for code from for till the end. All right, and go to your code and just going to paste it like this. Yeah, and make sure that you're just having the indentation in place. The for should be coming like exactly in the same line, so you can just like indent it like this. And this is the response that we get, and we are making use of that response here. And here also we need to make some changes. So first thing is we can remove this particular thing, because here we are getting the text also. This is only useful in case if you are going to get text as well as image in the output, but in our case we are not going to get that. We are just going to get only the image in the output. So for that we can just remove this part, and it's just going to be an if condition. So if part in response as inline data, then only we are passing it. Okay, and here also this is going to be like completely changed. So I will just remove the display, we don't need that. I will remove the print, we also don't need that. And I'll also remove the mime type. All right, so we'll just remove these. So it's going to be data equal to part dot inline data dot data. Next thing is we will be decoding the data that we get. So it's going to be decoded underscore data equal to base64. That's the reason why we imported it. We are just decoding it. Base64 dot, we will be having this B64 decode, and inside that we will pass the data, the value that we have got over here. And next we need to have a image path. All right, it's going to be image underscore path equal to, here we can just keep a name. I will just have it as edited image, something like this. So you need to have it with the extension dot png. All right, and next we'll be having the path lib. So this is basically used to write our decoded data or the image into this particular path. So we need to import this path lib. So you can just copy this and come to the top. It's going to be import path lib. All right, and just scroll here. It's going to be path lib dot path, and inside that you need to pass your image path, which is this variable, and it's going to be dot write bytes, and inside that we need to pass our decoded data, something like this. So now just come outside of this for loop. So it will be like straight line, and you're just going to have a if condition. If image path exist, we'll be just sending that file. Okay, it's going to be return. We'll be using the send file. This is from Flask, which we imported. Basically we'll be just sending the image. So image path will contain that particular image. So it's going to be send file image path, and we'll be also sending the type of the image, which is mime type equal to, it's going to be image slash png, and we'll be also having a else condition. What if we got some error and we didn't get that image path? It's going to be return. You'll just send a error message. JSONify is also from Flask, and open curly brackets. We will just have a error message saying error, and it seems to be outside. We can just have it as error something. You can just have it like this, and the status is going to be comma 500. All right, and now we need to start our Flask. So for that you can just come to this corner. Yeah, we'll be having our main function. So it's going to be if space underscore underscore name space double equal to space double equal to, we'll be having within single quote underscore underscore main underscore underscore, it's going to be colon, and inside that we'll just have app, which is our Flask variable dot run. That's it. If you want, you can just have debug here equal to true, and that's up to you. All right, so this is basically the code, and let's see if it works. So we are getting an error. It says must start with a slash. So you're having the path, right? Make sure that you're putting a slash over here. Now again, save it and run it. It's going to be Python your file name.py to run. Yeah, now it is running. So now we need to copy this path under this particular URL. So just copy this URL, and this is a post operation. So go to postman. It's going to be post here, and paste the URL, put a slash, and also copy this edit image thing. Yeah, like this. And next we will be sending our prompt as well as the image. So you need to go to body, you need to go to body, and it will be none by default. Click on form data, and here you'll be having the key, right? You'll be having a small drop down. Select that and make sure that you are selecting file. Click here and have the key as image, because here we are having it as image, right? So select files, click here, and here you need to select the file that you want. I will just go with this car and open it. Yeah, so I'll just show you that image. So this is the image that I will be sending, and next is going to be the prompt. So I'll just have here as prompt. This is going to be a text, so don't change the type over there. So I'll just have the prompt as change to blue. All right, it's red in color now. I'm just asking it to change to blue color, and I will just send it. So we have got the response, and as you can see here, I'm getting that exact car in blue color. So in case if you're having a front end like an app or a website, you can just display that image, or else if you want to save it, you can just save it to a file. And here you are having the edited image. So this was the original image, and this is the image that we get after the response. And I guess we'll be also getting a copy over here. For example, in our files, here you can see we are having the copy as edited image. So you can just make use of it. And let me go through the code again. Basically, we are importing a bunch of things over here. Most important things being Flask and Google GenAI, which is basically used to create a endpoint. This is used to, you know, connect with Gemini's API. After this, we are creating a Flask variable and connecting to Gemini API with passing their API key. And here we are defining the route, which is a post operation, and we are passing the image and prompt from Postman. Here we are accessing it, and then we are sending it to Gemini's model. And here you need to specify text and image. These are the output, you know, response types. So here we are passing prompt as well as image. Then it gives the response. And in the response, we'll be also having a lot of metadata. But in that metadata, we are only filtering the particular part, the part which has the data, which is the edited image. Then we are decoding that particular image, and we are just storing in this particular path. After storing it, we are just sending the image. And if the image isn't there, we are sending an error. And once everything is fine, we are getting the image in our output. So if you want to give another prompt and open doors, send, doors are opened in this particular car. So that looks amazing. You can just have a front end and display it in the UI. In case if you feel it is so hard to follow, you can just basically copy this whole code and put it in your VS Code and literally copy and ask literally ChatGPT to convert this to an API format. So that's also a quick solution. And I hope you'd have found this video useful, guys. Do check the playlist of my channel. I've done a lot of videos in Gemini AI, OpenAI API, and AI tools and programming in general. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.